Hey, what's up? This is Jamal Abbott here to show you how to use analytics for 8x8 work. So, want to show you what this looks like if you're into data, if you're into looking into how many people are calling into your phone system, or maybe how busy the people in your company are. This is a great place to take a look at the data and then really start to make some decisions. Before we jump into this, I want to show you how to set this up for either one user or for a couple users in your organization. But first, we're going to go to our admin console and we're going to figure out how to set this up. And just keep in mind, I've only looked into this here recently since I've been very busy with making phone calls. So I thought this would be a good time to do a video on the analytics feature of your 8x8 phone system. So go to users. We want to make sure that our user account is set up for the analytics package. And I'm going to go to my account. And then down here in the bottom left-hand corner, we see analytics for 8x8 work. So go ahead and click that. It's going to take you to the permissions. And you see here that my account is enabled for analytics essentials. If you click the drop-down box, you can also set it to do not allow access to analytics for 8x8 work. But I want that, so that's what we have there. We're gonna jump back here, and then you see here from the application panel, right next to my 8x8 is analytics for work. So if you have access to this feature set, this pops up as soon as you log in to the application panel. So click on analytics for 8x8 work, and it's gonna load up. It's gonna show you a nice little graph of what's going on with your company. First thing you see here is the company summary, and it shows the date of today, which is October 9th. And there's a few options that you can see here. So total inbound calls, outbound calls, extension type calls, and then any missed calls or abandoned calls. So lots of data here, lots of good information that you can make some decisions and really make some changes to your organization, or possibly maybe try to understand what your customers are up to. You know, why are they calling at certain times of the day? Or maybe understand what your agents or your employees are doing during certain times of the day. So what I want to do is point out that we have some menu options here. So of course we have home, call reports, employee reports, an option for meetings. So just give you some stats on how active meetings are in your organization. And then this little option here to pop out the menu. So we're just going to kind of pop that out here real quick. And then we see that we actually have more of a visual detail of what's going on here with these different menu options. So we'll go ahead and pop that back. And what I want to do first, just because I want to show you how busy I've been in September, and not to brag here, I just want to show you some good data here. We're going to go here towards the very top with this calendar, and it's going to pop up a menu option, and it's going to give you options for today, yesterday, the last 7 days, 30, last month, or a custom range. What I want to do is I'm going to select last month here, and it's going to generate the report of what was happening for the month of September. So I told you I wasn't lying. I've been a little busy here with phone calls, and you see here from the graph some total inbound calls, outbound calls, and then extension to extension calls. With this menu, you can also break this up. I'm not a real big fan of seeing these bar graphs kind of on top of one another like this, so I'm going to change the view just a little bit. And there's this little graph here, and this little menu says I can change the graph type, so I'm going to go ahead and do that. And I can choose from stack, column, line chart, area chart, pie chart. We'll just kind of run through those here real quick. So that's the stack, which is the one I don't like. The column chart, I think it, to me, it just gives you a better representation of what's happening here between outbound calls and inbound calls and extension calls. Line chart, if you're into that kind of stuff, it'll give you, just kind of a summary of how many calls were made. So for instance, on the 10th of September, we see that there's 35 total outbound calls and then three inbound calls and then no extension calls. And then area chart. And then lastly, a pie chart. So depending upon how you want to see the data, you can organize it in the manner that makes most sense to you. And if you want to screenshot this, or if you want to take this information and then use it in some other type of report, you can choose a chart that makes the most sense for you to do that. I'm going to go back here to column chart just because, like I said, I like that view. And then we can see here with the call summary, the top number here is 40. And then for the summary for this particular company, 35 calls was the max once again, and that was on September 10th. And then the lowest was just under 5 calls. So looks like there was 4 calls total, and then for outbound calls, and then for inbound calls, 3 calls altogether. So like I said, lots of data here. Let's go ahead and kind of scroll down, and then we're going to focus more so on the time stats. So we have stats here for total time spent on the phone, average time, total talk time. We have some inbound stats, some outbound stats, and then extension stats. So I'm just going to kind of look here at the total call time. So this is measured in the hours. Average talk time is about 5 minutes and 27 seconds. And let's see here, total ring time. This is an interesting number here. So 47 minutes of total ring time. And then the average ring time is about 7 seconds. And if you're a telephone geek, you may know that the average ring cycle is about 4 seconds per ring. So it looks like I'm answering most of these calls within the first 2 rings. Abandoned time. So this is not a good number, and especially if you're maybe like in a sales type organization, or maybe an organization that serves customers, you definitely don't want to see this high number in the abandoned call time. So that's an indication of people calling to maybe your business or maybe to your organization, and then eventually just changing their mind and hanging up. So maybe there was not enough people to answer the phones. Or maybe they could have been, it could have been any number of things, but we'll just pretend here that there just wasn't enough people to answer the phones, and that's the reason why they hung up. So, and then voicemail calls, 24. So, inbound stats, and once again, outbound and extension to extension stats. So, I'm not gonna bore you too much here. I just wanna kind of point out a couple things that you get lots of good data here with. Your 8x8 phone system and understanding how calls are being handled in your organization. And company summary beta, this is something that it may come online at some point in time. It's just something that they haven't chose to activate yet. But it gives you a different view of the same data that we were looking at, but in little bit more organized format, and then highlighting some of more of the important stats down here. So let's see if we can go back here to the last month, take a look at that data. And once again, total inbound calls, outbound calls, extension. I believe we can click, yeah, so we click here, and then it only shows you the data that you need to see. So these are the total number of inbound calls. So Friday the 11th, 12 total inbound calls. Let's see, we'll go back here to outbound calls. And then here on the 28th, 23 outbound calls altogether. So once again, the data is a little bit more clean in this format. And it looks like we can download some of this additional data here if we want to either view it or download it for something else later down the road. So at this point, I'm just gonna start kind of clicking around. Like I said, I'm not too familiar with this analytics tool, but it's interesting to see some of the data that's popping up. So extension summary, so we can see how busy the extensions are. So if you have an auto attendant, this is kind of a good thing to look at here too. If you have an auto attendant or ring groups, you can see how active this has been. I'm gonna change this view and let's go to monthly and we'll go back to September. So we see that extension 1001 has been the most active, which is Jamal Abbott, that's me. And we can kind of see how active this has been for the month of September. So like I said, lots of good data and information that we're looking at. These numbers down here, these are ring groups. So this is, that has something to do with, like if you have like a sales team or maybe like a support team, you can see how active that support team or sales team has been with the ring group and then looking at the stats for that. So call detail records. Once this pops up, we'll see some data about the calls coming in and out of the organization. So if you need to look up a specific call and then see how long that person has been on the phone, or maybe there was a conversation that you really need to get the details for, you can come here and look at this data here. And let's see, we'll go to just one more menu, unreturned calls. This looks like another interesting one. So these are the missed calls that have taken place in your organization. So I want to go back to the last month. Once again, that was the month that had a lot of data. And then you can see here the call ID, the leg, the start time, who called, the name of the caller, and then the extension that they called. So like I said, lots of good data here to look at and to go through and process. Lastly, we'll go here to meetings. And once again, this is related to the 8x8 Meet platform. And then you can see how busy your employees or people in your organization, how busy they've been with meetings. So maybe this is a good indication of meetings taking place to get sales or to get new partnerships done. So you can use that information however you see fit and make some decisions off of that. So I'm a big believer in that you let the data drive your decisions. And with this analytics tool for 8x8 work, you certainly get a lot of data at your disposal. So let the data drive your decisions and allow these decisions to be intelligent decisions. So no longer you have to go off of a whim, use the data to your advantage and use it in an intelligent way. So this is Jamal Abbott. Thanks so much for tuning in and checking this out. If you have any questions, let me know, drop them in the chat, and then let me know if there's anything else that you want to see from this platform, or if you just have any other questions about analytics. So we'd love to hear your feedback in the comments. Thanks again for watching, and I'll talk to you soon.